All right, number eight. Our Laplace transform. And I'm going to break this one up as well. Let's write this as S over S squared plus pi squared would be our first term. And then our second term would be e to the negative 2s. Over s squared plus pi squared. So, what's the very first thing we'd want to do? The inverse Laplace of? Okay, so it's going to be the same for both, isn't it? This would be cosine pi t. Okay. All right, the first part is not a Heaviside function. The first part's just the cosine, right? The second part, I do have to apply the Heaviside function. So it would look like u of t minus 2. And then it would be cosine of pi times t minus 2 . Let's deal with this cosine pi of t minus 2 . This is the same thing as cosine of pi t minus 2 pi . What's that now?
Would that be the same as saying cosine pi t minus 1? Like, not in parentheses, but...
No, in parentheses it was t minus 2. The shift was at 2. The reason I put it together is because now I can say this is the same thing as cosine pi t cosine 2 pi minus sine pi t sine 2 pi. What is the cosine of 2 pi? That's 1. What's the sine of 2 pi? That's nice. That whole thing just goes away. So really, this just boils down to cosine pi t minus u of t minus 2 cosine pi t, right? Is that right? Okay. So, I'm going to have cosine of pi t minus 0 if t is smaller than 2. And then cosine of pi t if t is greater than or equal to 2. And I can actually put these together. This one says this function right here has a value of cosine pi t all the time, no matter what t is. This one has restrictions. So, this is going to have a value of cosine pi t minus 0 if t is less than 2. And it's going to have a value of cosine pi t minus cosine pi t if t is greater than or equal to 2. Again, I just think about distributing. So for this one, it's going to be cosine of pi t when t is less than 2, but it's going to be 0 otherwise. When you graph it, then what happens is you just get one period of a cosine curve. And your period is 2, so. It looks like this. And then after that, it's always 0. Any questions so far? All right, so what I want you to do with that is I want you to figure out how to solve equations. So flip over to page 324.